lot of ground on diversity and what it means to acknowledge somebody's differences. But I want to take it a step further, because I don't think it's enough just to acknowledge somebody's differences. I think we need to take value and stock in those differences, celebrating one's own uniqueness. See, there's a word for that. That word is equity. You see, if somebody didn't take equity in me and value and stock in my life when I was a custodian, working nights and going to school during the day, I wouldn't be here in front of you tonight. I really wouldn't. I'd like to offer a challenge to our keynote speakers, administration, and professionals in the room. Imagine a time when somebody took value and stock in your life and showed you equity and the path it set you on and how it shaped your future. You see, if you've been around me long enough, you've been in meetings or a current student or just anybody who will listen, I use this analogy, so please just bear with me. You see, equality says everybody gets a bicycle, regardless if you ever rode a bicycle, regardless if you're from a region or an environment that supports the use of a bicycle, regardless if you've ever seen a bicycle, regardless if you understand the mechanics, the engineering, the pedals, the tires, the chains of that bicycle. And then equality says, we want you to perform like somebody else who had a bicycle before they were born. Learn to use a bicycle before they could walk. And you would say, hold up, that's not fair. This person has an advantage. And then equality says, well, what are you complaining for? We gave you a bicycle. You see where I'm going with this? You see, equity takes it a step further. Equity says, I'm not only going to give you that bicycle, I'm going to give you the tools to perform on that bicycle, to ride on that bicycle, pop wheelies on that bicycle, break that bicycle down, build it back up, and then take it to your community and train others to ride that bicycle. You see, that's what we do here at Stockton. That's what we get right, equity. It's our mission. It's literally in our mission statement. When you get a chance over the weekend, please look up our mission statement. See, we don't want you to have some static experience or just throw you in classes. We want to give you a voice. We want to give you the tools to go back to your community and be successful and help others. Because what good is education and knowledge if you don't use it to empower others? What if Einstein, after finding the scientific research, wouldn't have shared it with the world? What if Dr. King, after getting his doctorate, didn't pursue the ministry? What if Edison, after inventing the light bulb, just threw his hands up? We'd be sitting here in the dark. Education without a purpose is worthless. I don't care if you go to Harvard or if you go to night school. Education without a purpose is worthless. And when I say community, I mean it in the broadest sense. I mean humankind. I mean society. So if somebody in our community hasn't been given the tools to become successful, that's not a reflection on them. That's a reflection on us. That's a reflection on us. So if you're in this room tonight, I don't care your stature, your race, your ethnicity, your political affiliation, it is your responsibility to preserve that equity. Now I'm going to leave you with these last words, and these will be my last words, because my colleagues remind me so graciously that I'm long-winded. But when I first started in the missions and I was trying to figure out my responsibilities, I remember I asked my friend and mentor, a former colleague who has served Stockton for over 32 years, Mr. Melvin Gregory, who ironically couldn't be with us tonight because he's out still serving his community, what he looked for when he recruited students. You see, Mr. Mel has recruited hundreds of students, thousands of students, some of whom you heard from tonight. And if you know Mel, he's very smooth, he has a baritone voice, so I'm gonna try to do my best impression. But he said, brother, you don't know we're jewelers? I looked at my job description, I said, I don't see anything about jewelry on here. And he said, what does a diamond look like in its rawest form? And I said, cool. And he said, correct, diamonds in the rough. We look for individuals who face extreme pressures, racial pressures, economic pressures, social pressures, emotional pressures, and took that pressure and forged something beautiful, diamonds. Diamonds of all colors, shapes, and sizes. Black diamonds, blue diamonds, yellow diamonds, red diamonds, clear diamonds, and so on and so forth. And like those diamonds, under extreme pressure, it has created a clarity so bright it has a glowing result of success. So when I look out at this crowd tonight, that's what I see. Beautiful, precious diamonds in the rough, who are not here by some chance or some mistake, but by facing the pressures of the world and never breaking. So with that being said, keep shining, my friends. Good night. God bless. Safe travels.